Okay, if you use any of these phrasal verbs, they all mean include in some kind of way, which is a bit like rope someone in. Yeah, when you rope someone in, you include them in your activity. But you could also say, let's say you try and rope in your friend and he says, "Oh, okay then, count me in." It means include me, count me in as a member of the team, include me on the football team. And that he would say that if he had decided to join in, to participate simply, to join in. If you join in, you decide to be included in the activity. You decide to participate. And you could also say you opt in, which is when you choose to be included. Yeah? Opt from option. When you opt to do something, you opt in. Yeah? If you maybe you opt in, maybe you opt out, in which case you decide not to join in. Okay, and if you include something in the price, you price it in. So I might say for my lessons, I price in the cost of materials as well. I write a lot of the materials for TV shows, which is incidentally why I don't bother answering anybody who talks about lights, camera, microphone, writing too small. I'm sorry, I'm too busy to answer those comments, so they always will get deleted immediately. And yeah, it's because I'm too busy writing other things, materials for the students who come to the lessons, and all of that is priced in. Okay, you can also say to jack in your job, which means to quit, or to pack in your job, which again means to quit. So to jack something in or pack something in, it means stop doing something, but it's really often used for job, work, or projects when you suddenly decide to throw in the towel. There's another expression, throw in the towel, throw in there, throw in the towel, stop doing something, throw in the towel. I imagine it's a sport idiom, but I'm not sure there. But when you throw in the towel, you jack it in, you pack it in, you stop doing it. Now, if you're parking your car and somebody boxes you in, this means that you've parked your car and somebody's parked very close at the front, someone else's car has parked very close at the back of the car, and you can't get out now. You are boxed in. It could be used in some other similar situations, but it basically means your freedom of movement has been restricted. And the same with when you fence someone in, but this one is used metaphorically as well. Okay, let's come on to sink in and take in. These both mean absorb information. So don't worry, these phrasal verbs do take a long time to sink in, but do it gradually, do it step by step, and they will sink in. You have to phase these phrasal verbs in, which means do it in phases, step by step, gradually, and eventually they do sink in. All young people in England use these phrasal verbs because they're certainly there in children's books everywhere. In fact, read any children's books, any children's book, and you will see many of these phrasal verbs, I guarantee it. Okay, if you bring in a new law, this is very often used legally for laws and rules and legislation. If you bring in new legislation, then you introduce a new law, that's all. And if you phase in new legislation, it means you bring it in slowly, step by step, gradually. And I thought these were quite similar to when you pencil something in. When you pencil something in, it means you put something on your schedule or timetable, but it's just provisional. And that means that it might be changed in future. So the idea is that you use a pencil so you can rub it out if you change your mind. You don't pen it in, you pencil it in, and then you can rub it out and change that if you need to. So I might say to one of my students, "Let's pencil your lesson in for Tuesday at 9 o'clock. But if you want to cancel, just let me know and I'll call it off." Okay? If you sign in to Facebook, I think everyone knows this really, you log on with your password. Very easy one. Now, if you rub something in, this basically means add insult to injury, and it's from the expression to rub salt into the wound. If you rub salt into the wound, then you get someone who's already hurt and make it hurt even more. I think kids do this when they win a competition or a game. Very often, they're not very good winners, and they're not very good losers either, but when they see that the other child is upset because they've lost, they rub it in. They say, yeah, I'm the champion, you lost, ha ha ha, you're rubbish, blah blah blah, and they add insult to injury. They rub it in. Now, if you rein something in, or rein something back, by the way, which is pretty similar, then this is a horse riding expression. The reins are what you have to control the horse. And if you rein something in, you stop or slow down this something. You can rein in spending. If you're a businessman and you own your own company and you spend a lot of money on it, and you think, next year I'm going to rein in spending, it means next year you're going to limit spending. You're going to stop spending so much. You're going to slow down spending. Because when you rein in the horse, you slow the horse down. And it's very often used for reining in the emotions as well. I think horses very often represent the emotions metaphorically in several pieces of literature, and for this reason we say to rein in your anger or something like that, to stop or slow down or limit your anger. So it can be used for controlling the emotions too. Okay, if you are raking in the cash, then you are receiving loads and loads of cash. This phrasal verb is from the garden tool a rake, which is shaped like that. Yeah, we all know what it feels like to step on a rake. It's that thing where you step on it and it hits you in the nose. Well, when you're raking in the cash, the image I see in my head is of a person with a rake raking up all those £50 notes. So they're raking in loads of money. They're making loads of money. But you can rake in other things. It doesn't have to be cash. And it just means to receive a lot of something. So you might be raking in the customers, in which case it's very similar to reel in, which is not a garden image now, it's a fishing image. The fishing reel is when you're fishing. And when you reel in a fish, you pull in the fish towards you. Yeah, you're reeling it in when you're doing that, and the fish is getting closer and closer. So it means attract a lot of, very similar to receive a lot of, yeah? And so you can reel in the customers. If you've got a new promotion, your business is promoting the product in a new way, you might say, I'm reeling in hundreds of customers at the moment. Okay? And it just means attracting hundreds of customers. And by the way, you can rake up the leaves. That's usually what we'd say for leaves in the garden. You're raking up the leaves. So we generally use a different preposition when it's with leaves. But raking in the cash, yeah, it sounds like you're just putting loads of cash into the business. Now, if you fall in with a bad crowd, and it seems to me it's often used with a bad crowd rather than a good crowd, it means you start hanging with a bad group of people. You can fall in with thieves, or you could fall in with drug addicts or something like that, and it means start hanging around with that particular group. Now, another one, we have a lot of words, a lot of phrasal verbs especially, for inform on someone, which would be the official formal way of saying it. When you inform on someone, you tell the police about their bad activity. But you can also dob someone in, or turn someone in, or even turn someone over to the police. Yeah, turn someone over to the authorities. So these two, they mean grass up. Grass up is another way of saying to inform on someone. Rat on would be another one, a much less formal way of saying it, to rat on someone, to snitch on someone. A snitch is a person who rats on his friends. So a snitch is someone who grasses up other people. Okay, so dob someone in, turn someone in, rat on someone, snitch on someone. We've got loads of words for this, absolutely loads of words. Okay, if you do someone in, it could mean to do away with someone, i.e. I mean to kill someone in its most extreme sense. It could even mean to beat someone up. Yeah, it could mean to beat someone up, do someone in, like bash their head in, smash their head in, do someone in. But it could also mean to tire you out or tire someone out. So you might say the marathon did me in. I couldn't breathe for hours properly after that. Yeah, I was out of breath. It did me in. It tired me out. So it's another way that do someone in is used. It's used in a number of ways. And if somebody has it in for you, it means that they bear a grudge. against you. It's very negative. If the boss has it in for you, it means he wants to get rid of you. He wants to do away with you. Doesn't necessarily mean kill, could mean get rid of. And if he has it in for you, he wants to get rid of you. He doesn't like you for some reason. So very similar to bear a grudge. Okay, if we say the a person caved into someone else, well, let's first deal with a building. If a building caves in, if the walls cave in, it means that the walls collapse. And so a building can cave in, or you could smash someone over the head and their skull could cave in. The same thing, it's the skull collapsing. So it can be used in a literal sense, but it could also be used in a metaphorical sense. If you cave into the kidnapper's demands, then you pay them money and get your loved one back. But maybe it's something much less dramatic. Maybe your wife has demanded that you move your tools out into the garden, and you don't like it. You don't want your tools to get rusty. You don't want your tools to get in bad condition. But eventually, you cave into her demands, you give in to what she's saying, because I think it's exactly the same as give in to someone, and you take the tools and bring them into the garden. So you cave in under pressure, you collapse under pressure, and you give in to what somebody is demanding of you. But you can cave in to anybody, not just your loved ones. It could be kidnappers. Okay, that's a lot of information there. I'm sure that it's so much information, I've probably made several mistakes. If I have made any mistakes with spelling, or very likely, or anything else, please write them under the video. And if you have any comments about lights, cameras, microphones, words not written properly, don't like the colour of the walls, blah, 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 put them under the video and I'll happily delete them without a second thought. Thanks very much for watching, and I hope to see you all soon.